New Jersey. I loved my life growing up in New Jersey. It was a wonderful neighborhood where kids rode bikes out in the street and played together. I decided that it wasn't something that I could really make a career of. So I got a job in New York as a recruiter and moved to New York, where I lived for 7 years until I was pregnant with twins. In college, I became a little bit socially active, and it really wasn't until after my children were born that I decided that I need to start caring about this world that I'm going to leave these two little babies. I feel it's important for people to find what they're passionate about and advocate for that or do something about it. So for me, the focus has often been on women's issues, which is why I focus now on issues of sexual assault. I'm president of the board for the Center for Sexual Assault, and getting more women elected to public office. It was really hard because I was 6 months pregnant and I was confined to the house. My husband would take the car to the train station and I was really kind of stuck there. So until my kids were old enough to start joining play groups and they could make friends, that was when I was had the ability to start making friends. I actually think it was a natural progression. I was active in the PTO as soon as my kids entered kindergarten and was co-chair of the town fair for 2 years. I ran community service for the elementary school when my kids were younger, and then I became PTO president of the intermediate school. Just as that school was built, I was the first PTO president there. At the same time, I was president of other nonprofit organizations and on the board of the Town Veterans Affairs Committee. So I felt that becoming first selectman was just kind of a natural progression in increasing my community service. In a certain aspect, but I think I'm mostly a realist. Obviously, you want to have some sense of a vision for the community and where you want the town to go and to be. So I think it's important that you have that and you have a very idealistic view of that. But when it comes to implementing those policies and procedures and goals to get to that vision, I think it's important that you are a realist about what you can accomplish. By far, being able to give proclamations. I think the worst part is when you are dealing with residents that are in certain bad situations and you know that you don't have the ability to help them. I don't mind if a resident is screaming at me, but when you see a person who comes forward that has a true problem and you know that there's nothing you can do to intercede, that I think was the worst part of the job for me. A lot of the community-wide structures such as the LaShotte Farm, the Senior Center, and Lights on the Ball Field. If I have absolutely nothing to do and it's a rainy day, then I'm happy to sit on the couch with a book all day and just kind of curl up and read. But I love the outdoors and I love being in Weston for that reason. So when the weather is nice, I'm out walking every day. I have a 4 mile loop that I do, or I walk up to the den and take a hike through the den. And to me, that's what's best about Weston, is that I have the ability to do that. I read fiction. All over, mostly alternative rock. Honestly, I want to say Jane Goodall. And the reason why I say that is because, number one, she became my hero when I was in college and studying anthropology. But also because not only did she look at chimps as a community and how they interact, but she was the one who first showed me that you have to care about the greater world and about what you're doing to impact that world. Go for it. Obviously, the Women's Campaign School. And I'm president of the board for the Center for Sexual Assault, Crisis Counseling, and Education down in Stamford, which covers Weston. So those are my two causes that I'm working on. I'm actually pretty proud of what I accomplished. You know, I never grew up thinking that I would enter a life in politics or public service or even become president of a nonprofit board or president of the PTO or any of that. I thought I would just kind of follow the footsteps of my mother and become a mom and raise my kids and enjoy my life. And I'm just glad that I felt a greater calling to do some good for this community. And I'm honestly quite proud of what I accomplished. I also feel there's a time you get to a stage in your life when you have to learn to step back, let the younger generation come and make this the world that they want it to be.